We have a Chinese stock boom. Cue the fire. Record amounts of retail investors. Hey, YOLO. You guys are piling into these Chinese companies. And Cathie Woods. We call her Comeback Cathie. She's going to be coming back and buying some more. I mean, 1 minute, the hedge funds are like, we've lost so much money, over 50%. And now they're like, well, I guess it's safe to come back in the water. So we're going to be looking at Chinese stocks today, Cathie Woods today, Wood, singular, and the beloved crypto, and my long position on BTC, and when I'm going to exit. See, I gotta be honest, just like with my Bravo's watch list, that you guys keep doing it and not doing my regular swing trading, then you email me like, so what again is a full candle close? And should I've already lost like 5%, should I just hold it? I'm like, no, Stimmy, Timmy, or Jimmy, you have an exit strategy. You go through the course and you're like, so this is when I get out. My Bravo's watch list just teaches you when to get in. You will not know when to naturally pull out. Trust me, I have 6 girls. But on this channel, I showed you when I got into Bitcoin. And now I'm gonna give you, and there was one reason why, and that was back in July. And now I'm gonna give you 10 reasons why I'm gonna start taking money off the table, and no, it does not have to do with fundamentals. And here we go, retail, oh wait, pardon me while you subscribe. Retail investors have bought 400 million of US listed Chinese stocks this week. You like the hand motions? The largest in 5 years. So the question is, are you gonna get wrecked? Well, we will have to take a look and see. Oh, he got wrecked. He started to be like entrepreneur. He thought he had freedom, America. Ah, all of a sudden, Jack Ma, where's he been for 3 years? Jack Ma is like China's Elon Musk, but can't have it over there. Sorry, Jack. Alibaba was the most. So we're going to look at that. Purchase single stock. I don't want you to get wrecked. In U.S. on Monday, and today is now Wednesday, I think, outpaced blank, Pfizer, I don't know. I say YOLO. If this is like a forever thing, right? You may want to, now I'm joking. I said that to an Austin bartender, and I was talking about alcohol. I'm like, well, if they're going to do lockdowns for the next decade or 100 years or century, I'm YOLOing in alcohol. And so he ran off and bought shares of alcohol companies. I'm like, that is not how you do it. It looks like the market's a little kind of flat. Probably has something to do with Jackson's hole, but I don't want to look there. We're going to be looking at this. Oh, I won't cover his story. I don't even know. 13 and 21. They are. It's similar. I don't even know what that's. I don't know what Nico Muscle has to say, but it is actually 13, 7, like every single bull market. We get trapped. We're like, ooh, we're going to the moon. And then, right, it pulls back. 10-year yield. I got to have Steven on. Let's talk about that. Ooh, yield, it's up today. Oh, are we going to have a taper tantrum? 30-year popping up. Dollar flat, TLT, the bond market. A little soft today and Bitcoin. But we came for Zibaba right here. B-A-B-A at 169. I actually remember not my very first trade, one of my trades way back in the day, over 20 years ago, 20-something, was Facebook. Oh, look at Alibaba. It was at 69. I just want to say it went 69, went up, it went down, it came back to 69. I sold, I broke even. Welcome to the beginning of Bravo's trading career. But that's what people do. Honestly, like they'll buy a stock and they're like, yeah, I'm up. And they let it ride, okay? And it goes up, 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 and they'd never sell. They're like, oh, never sell. And then it goes down, 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 down past their number, right? And then it goes past it, and they're like, wow. And then it comes back up to their, and they get out, and they're like, whew, I broke even. Now, wouldn't it be a little bit more, would there be more wisdom if maybe you took profits on the way up? I'm just thinking, okay, so here we go. Here's Alibaba. Do you buy this? Do you buy this? This has had a beatdown of beatdowns. And the answer is, if I'm trading on the daily, no. If you are a swing trader, okay, so if you are currently a swing trader, the answer is no. Now, if you're a different type of investor, I'm sorry, not an investor, those are the holders. Those are, you buy gold every single day, you buy silver, you buy Bitcoin, you never sell. That's an investor. I'm talking about traders. Traders that set stops, right? Because you don't want to lose too much money. Let's take a little gander. Actually, before I do that, let me move this. Let me double click there. And let's see how much of a beatdown we've had. Because didn't I say it was about 50%? How close am I? 52% has been beaten down. Now, if you are a trader, this is your less risk zone. That is your more risk zone. Less, more. Get it? Also, if you see a bunch of numbers on this, that has nothing to do with swing trading. So all of you that are in my swing trading course, just do what you've been taught. It's very simple. Now, for those of you that are going to be in my crypto course, if you choose that, because I have to use 100 different things. Swing trading is way easy. Stick with that. Now, crypto, different beast, different asset class. The number 9, that is it. After 9, you can come back in. Actually, on this one, on the daily, it sold off a few more. Gave back a couple more. Way oversold. Now we start a number 1. And whether or not Alibaba is oversold, oh yes. We can go all the way back. See the Mac? I'll show you this. Even when markets are way down, we have never been in these kind of oversold conditions. Actually, let me see if we've ever been in these kind of... We beat everything. And let me Alibaba myself. All right, there we go. I am now invisible. You are in subprime, the best ever. This is it. You are so oversold. So, if you're interested in putting a little paper trade right there, just make sure you have your stops in place. Don't want you to lose too much money. Remember, this, let me draw an L, less risk. This is B, big risk. Also, some zones of support, which you just found it right there. There's one. May want to, put something in right there just in case. I don't want you losing any money. Your next one, pretty obvious. You had a little gap right there. Look at that gap. Right about there. You go underneath that and goodbye, Baba. But I don't know if you see this. We are currently at 169. Guess what that is? That is a very, very zone. That's a big zone. And that is a zone of what? Support. Look at this. That supported that for forever, like a whole year from 17 to 18. Support, support, support. How many times did it touch? Like, what is that? 10? Broke through it. Resistance, resistance, broke through it. So let's stay above that, and then let's see if we can move higher. But if you are in my easy swing trading course, you stay out of this one. Why? Because of that. We are in a downtrend, and you'll get wrecked. It's easier to make money when stocks go up than when stocks go down. Also, link in the description if you do not want to pay $1,000 for my course on doing that. It's going to be around 300 and something. Then you can go to a bar when a chick looks at you and she says, what do you do for a living? You're like, well, I'm a trader, equities. Yeah, I have a lot of money. And then she says, that's great. Could you put some babies in my oven? And then you say, I most certainly can. When would you like to start? Hedge funds, good old hedge funds. They're always on the wrong side of everything. Dump Chinese stocks. Hopefully it was when Cathie was dumping. She gave off first warning shot, but she's coming back with a vengeance. Baby, come back. You can put it all on me. You need to know the song. Stocks at record pace, setting stage for a furious rebound. So even though I was beating up on Chinese stocks right about the same time Cathie Wood was... we're going to have a reversal, and there is some money to be made. But also know that, remember all those support and resistance lines? That's when everyone was like getting out or getting in. So just know that the people that got in are going to want to get out to break even. So you know where your zones are if you need to get out or whatever you want to do. Not financial advice, because you will lose all your money. All we do is paper trade on this channel. Win. And you also have a lot of hedge funds that look like idiots right now. And they want to make their money back. The most popular hedge fund long positions have fared exceptionally what? Poorly in recent months. So they're like, come on, we're they're coming back. Just like Cathie. Here we go. China tech stock extends rally as Cathie Wood buys in. Baby comeback. I would show you this video, but it looks like it does not want to show you. Oh, and she's back. This isn't... Guys, this is not Cathie.
Rallying for a second day, sentiment was boosted by 10 cents.
I cannot say that word, sentiment. She just said it. I repeated it. I got to actually watch that video. Cathie's not even in it. But that is not Comeback Cathie. And these guys are not, but they do sing that song. Baby, come back. You can put it all on me. I was wrong, and I just can't live without Cathie Wood. And I would much rather not have to sing, but I get demonetized if there is audio. I can't even like have like a just a little bit. I don't even know what I'm singing. I can't even get my voice up there. So all I get is like, ha ha, Mickey. Like, that's it. I can sing Mickey songs. Hedge funds. Always back. Hedge funds could be staging a comeback because they lost all their money as short bets post best month since 2010, which is easy. It's August. August is an YOLO short and make money. Short selling is booming again after being left for, because you guys got stopped out GameStop. Oh gosh, that must have been horrible. Now everyone's scared, like, I'm not clicking that button. Man, they just got wrecked. Yeah, those kids, diamond hands. GameStop kids, they'll squeeze everyone. They're like, I don't care if I lose money. Let's just squeeze them. And you can see the annual net flows. Oh, we're coming back up. Here we go. Oh, and by the way, for those of you that are thinking, you know, I'm going to invest my money with this fund manager, a hedge fund manager. Just know, they're not going to win. Here. We can go back to 2013, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. And let's take a look. Here's the S&P 500. Win, wrecked. Win, wrecked. Both wrecked. Go to gold. No, dollar. Go dollar. Gold, whatever. Gold's money. Just whatever, gold. S&P 500, hedge fund, wrecked. These are SPY. And if you wanted to know which one, if you like, well, how do I do this? How do I take control of my own finances? Here, I'll do it in, can I do it in one click? Don't click there. Don't click S&P 500 mini. No. You have to go one more indices, SPX. And then you come over here and you click, right? Oh, look at this wedge still going. For you non-traders, I laugh because it's going to break. Just like the 4 hour of Bitcoin. One moment. I'll take you there in just a second. You click trade, create new order. But lo and behold, you cannot trade SPX. So Johnny Bravo lied to you. It's actually SPY. So you'll click right up here, SPY. Click enter. There we go. Right click, trade, buy. Booyah. Done. I made a trade. You see, that's easy, right? Gosh, that's that. Here, there you go. You took my course. You didn't even take my course. See, look, I just showed you. Oh, you want to close your position? Oh, okay. Let's close our position. Yes. Okay. It's actually canceled. It was a limit order. It was not a market order. So it did not fill. If you want, I don't know what time it is right now. Boom. This one will get filled. Oh, it got rejected. See, I wasn't looking at the time. I mentioned it. I'm like, oh, what time is it? Didn't make that trade. But here cometh the Bitcoin trade. And I told you that where am I going to take profits? Right, hopefully in this zone right there. But don't let me trigger you investors. You investors, you just buy and hold. It's okay. I'm talking to traders. Investors are like, you just wait. You come back in 5 years or whatever. You know what, okay, all right. You got me. I can make a lot more money, me, not you, on down moves, on up moves. If you know what's going to happen, probabilities. I don't know. All of a sudden, Bitcoin can go to a million. I mean, I would be very happy. I was actually looking at going back in my whatever trades. 2016, I started looking at Bitcoin because my students are like, the high school thing. And I was developing a company, software. My developer was like, dude, I bought this Bitcoin for $800. And I'm like, ooh, wow, that's crazy. It's not even real. Because if you're a gamer, you know, like you, digital currency has just always been around. And I remember when Bitcoin, I do remember reading articles when Bitcoin went to $1. I'm like, wow, it beat the dollar. Well, that didn't take much. But then in time, you start doing research. You're like, oh, hey, this is a great concept. I mean, take away price. Crypto, Bitcoin, Hey, everyone always gets hung up on price. Now, do you guys see something that I that I see? Do you see what I see? Actually, it's going to bring us right into my zone. Here, I'll draw something for you. And here, I drew my very first line. Good job. Do you guys see it yet? And here, how about now? You see it? Oh, the magical wedgie. There we go. So where do you think it's going to break down? Actually, it really respected. Let me just zoom in for you so you can see it. Starts down here, respected each one. Oh, look at that. Right off the tip. So yes, I do believe that Bitcoin has a lot more move to the upside until it comes down to the downside. And let me show you one more thing. Do you see which way this is going? See the price? It's going that way, right? Okay, so I'm gonna show you divergence. But there is no divergence if you're just waiting for that Lambo money. Do you see that direction? Ah, no. Spaghetti-o. I mean, I still might even get wrecked and it won't meet my target. I just want to meet my target. It's like, come on, FOMO, come on, retail, get it up. And also, if you want to know where I put in that long position, I will pull this up so you can see it right there. That was on May. Oh, it wasn't July. I thought it was July. May 31st. There we go. Right in that zone. That was the biggest oversold I have ever seen. The Bitcoin. Look at this. Look at that. Look at that. Bam. Yep. I'll probably have to exit out at about 20, I don't know, 26. I'm waiting. Come on. Give it to me. You win some and you lose some. But yep, I will have to cut my loss. I'm not hodling for 20 years. I'll be buying down. If it goes down there. But for my traders, guys, this was a good run. Look, that was an amazing bull run. I remember it. I told you when I entered and exited on this one, I had the YouTube channel. This was great. This is nothing to shake a stick at. And I don't know if you shake sticks or what you shake them at, but if you go back here, do you see that? See that little top right there? Uh-huh. Yep, this is there's a secret. You can Google search stock market trader's secret. I probably said that wrong. See that? Now I'll be like, you see that? I'm like, just please. Let me touch my fib zone. That didn't sound right. Oh, and breaking news just came in from Bank of America. Oh, we got the biggest moves. Bank of America, I just saw this because I subscribed to Pro. Bank of America picks out gold nuggets in the volatile Chinese stock market. Well, let's see what you picked for us there. Bank of America. Yeah, so they probably can pick their nose better than stocks. We got down, up 0.5%, and coming in for the win, we have ANTA Sports Products. You just lost 7%. So congratulations, Bank of America. And another breaking news, Snowflake stocks making the biggest moves after Salesforce, Sonoma. My wife's really good at that place. Snowflake, that's me. Me, Kevin was pumping that. I remember back in the day. How are we doing? Let's just scroll. Let's give me the number. Give me some nothing. What? And it looks like snow. Earnings announcements after the market. I can't. Just keep me away from earnings calls. Down. Here we go. Down. Oh, up. So we went down today, 1.5%. It looks like we're popping. Why is it? That's not even a big deal. How wrecked did Skylar get on this one from top to bottom? Listening to YouTubers. Almost 57%. Yikes. And coming in on the swing trade on the daily. Look, you guys just got a little golden cross right there. Look, boop, there's your 280. That's your buy zone. Not for you, though. You do not buy. This is just me, not financial advice. Because I don't want to see you get wrecked. Watch. Let's see. Let's see if we're in the now we'll click on after hours and see if you're in the got wrecked zone. Click extend. Wish you could do that in real life. And 278 wrecked. Those are called intradays, and that is called earnings call. I hate them. And look how volatile it was yesterday. The day before, look at that. Almost 11%. I mean, 1 hour ago, that was like being thrown off a building. You're like, oh, we're going up, we're going down. We're going up, we're going down. That's not good. Also, do yourself a favor, and don't let hedge fund managers manage your money, because they're not going to win. Learn how to trade. That's why I give you big, deep discounts. Deep discounts. Thanks for making it to the very end, and I will see you tomorrow.